Hello friends, now we will solve the problem. So the question is, write the shear transformation of rectangle. Means we have to write the transformation matrix for shear. For rectangle ABCD in x direction by 2 units and in y direction by 2 units. So the rectangle is given and shearing parameter is given, which is in x direction by 2 units, and shearing parameters along y direction, it is 2 units, and the initial coordinates of rectangle has been given, that is A 2, 2, B 6, 2, C 6, 4, D 2, 4. So I will roughly draw the figure. The figure is not given in this problem. So this is a rectangle A, B, C, D. Its coordinate is given, and it also says that A is not in origin, which means that the coordinate for A is 2, 2. So we have to translate this point A to origin. Unless and until we don't translate the point A to origin, we can't perform shear transformation. So for that case, we will translate this point A to origin, and we will do shear transformation along x direction and shear transformation along y direction. So the first transformation I will do is translation transformation. So the solution, so first translation we will do, it is translate point A to origin. Means whenever the object is away from the origin, we will do translation. Means we will bring that object to origin, then only we can do the transformation, that is different transformations. So for translation we will require the value of Tx and Ty. Tx and Ty. So for bringing this point to origin, I will have to move in this direction for x, that is Tx, that is translation along x direction. So I am moving from right to left. The sign convention is negative, so I will write as -2. Means 2 units I have to travel, and since the sign convention is negative because I am moving from right to left. Similarly along y direction, so I am moving in downward direction and I have to travel 2 units, so the sign convention will be minus. The Ty will be -2. So we know the standard matrices for translation is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, Tx, Ty, 1. For this I will require the value of Tx and Ty. Now I will replace the value of Tx and Ty so that I will get the matrices for translation. So value of Tx is -2, the value of Ty is -2, and last it is 1. So this is the first translation transformation. So first transformation we have done is translation. So now the figure has been brought to the center. This figure is just for understanding purpose, which means that after applying translation transformation, the figure has been brought to center. So now, since the figure has been brought to center, we can easily perform shear transformation along x direction and y direction. So next transformation is x shear. So for x shear, I will require the value of shearing parameter, that is A. In this problem, it is given 2 units. So I will write it as 2. And the standard matrices for shear along x direction is given as 100, A 10, 001. So now quickly replace the value of A, that is 2, 100. The value of A is 2, 10, 001. So I got the matrices for shear transformation. Now the next transformation I will do, that is Y shear, because shearing parameter along Y direction is also given. For Y shear, I will require the value of B, which is also known as shearing parameter, but it is along Y direction. So we have to do Y shear. For Y shear, I will require the value of B. So in the problem, the shear transformation along Y direction is by 2 units. So the value of B is 2, and we know that the standard matrices for shear along Y direction is SHY, which is represented as SHY. The matrices is 1B 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So now I will replace the value of B. It will become 1 2 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So now I successfully transformed, that is shear transformation, along X direction and Y direction, but originally the figure was away from the origin, and for performing shear along X direction and shear along Y direction, we brought that object to origin. So now we will place it back to its original position. So for that I will do back translation. So last transformation I will do is back translation, that is translation, back translating point A. So for back translation, I will require the two parameters, that is Tx and Ty. After applying translation transformation, we brought this figure to origin. So now I will back translate. So I will move in this direction. So I have to move 2 units, both in X and Y direction. Since I am moving in positive direction, I will both take the value as plus 2 and plus 2. Or else just write opposite to that of translation which we have done first. So it is 2, 2, positive 2, positive 2. The standard matrices is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, Tx, Ty, 1. Now I will replace the value of Tx and Ty. Matrices I will get as 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 2, 1. So this is the matrices for back translation. So we successfully perform the transformation which we told in the problem. Now I will calculate the resultant transformation. So the resultant transformation formula is TR. Here we have done first translation transformation, then we have done shear transformation along X direction, then we have done shear transformation along Y direction, and lastly we have done back translation. So I will write down the matrices for corresponding transformation, that is 1 0 0 0 1 0 minus 2 minus 2 1. It is 1 0 0 2 1 0 0 0 1. For shear along Y direction, it is 1 2 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and for back translation it is 1 0 0 0 1 0, just opposite to this is 2 2 1. So now I will multiply all these matrices, then I will get the resultant transformation, that is TR. So after multiplying all the matrices, I got TR as 1, 2, 0, 2, 5, 0, -4, -12, 1. So this is resultant transformation, and we have to find the final position. So for that, the formula is final position of rectangle is equal to initial position of rectangle into TR. So we have to find the final position of the rectangle. So I will note down the initial position, that is initial position is A, B, C, D. So I will require the value of A, B, C, D. So I will convert the coordinates of A into matrices form. The coordinate was 2, 2. Now I will convert it into matrices form. So it will become 2, 2, 1. And similarly, for B, it is 6, 2, 1. And for C, it is 6, 4, 1. And for D, it is 2, 4, 1. And I have to multiply it with resultant transformation. Our resultant transformation is 1, 2, minus 4, 2, 5, minus 12, 0, 0, 1. So the order of this matrices is 4, 3, and the order of this matrices is 3, 3. So after multiplying both these matrices, I will get the value of final position of the rectangle, that is in the form of A dash, B dash, C dash and D dash. After multiplying the matrices, the value I got as A dash is 2, 2, 1, for B dash is 6, 10, 1, and for C dash is 10, 20, 1, and for D dash is 6, 12, 1. So now the final position, that is final one, I am naming by dash, so I will write as A dash. The coordinate for A dash is 2, 2. The coordinate for B dash is 6, 10. The coordinate for C dash is 10, 20. The coordinate for D dash is 6, 12. So we calculated the resultant transformation and final position of rectangle. Thank you.